Hvad var der svært ved det her?
Det vi lige har lavet. Alt det vi har lavet indtil nu i dag. Hvad var der svært ved det? Ja. Og stop på stopuret. Du siger?
Mållængden.
Ja. Du siger? Ikke forstået. Jeg tror, I var ikke at gået god.
Nu har jeg det her. Og så siger de... Skal jeg så... Øj, du er helt...
No home, no work. Can you find something that rhymes? Very often it's a good idea when you're smoking to find a rhyme. Very difficult to rhyme on homework, but you could rhyme on home or you could rhyme on work. If you're very good at it. Or you can rhyme on school, that's maybe easier. Or read. There's no need to read. Det er svært, det der. Synes jeg, det er noget rum og rum. Det er lidt med World Peace.
Segregation.
Det er et meget, meget vigtigt ord, det her. Det var i teksten. Var det ikke? Hvad betyder det?
Det betyder adskilt.
Fuldstændig rigtigt. Jeg fortalte nogen af jer om, at jeg har set billeder, I har set på nettet. Hvis I googler Martin Luther King, så kommer der sådan nogle billeder her frem, hvor der står.
Nå, så jeg ved ikke, mange
whites. Og på den anden står der, nu er det for amerikansk, så der er ikke noget ui. Colored. Der er to døre. To toiletter. To steder, man må drikke vand. Så det var godt ord for mass segregation. Christina?
Civil rights.
Civil rights.
Non-violent.
Non-violent. Ja.
Peace.
National Day. Det er sjovt, at Tobias siger det her nu, fordi på tirsdag, så skal vi høre en sang. Velkommen til at gå hjem og finde den. Så i forhøj.
Nu er Stevie Wonder.
Det er rigtigt. Den sang er grunden til, at man indførte den 15. januar, tror jeg det er, som nationaldag i USA.
Nej, det er den tredje mandag.
Og det er den tredje mandag, okay. Det er i nærheden af hans fødselsdag.
Ja.
Og det gjorde det Stevie Wonder, det synes han, det var
for dårligt tilbage sammen. Sangen er fra 1978, at der ikke var lavet en nationaldag til Martin Luther King. Så skrev han en sang om det, og på grund af den sang, plus en masse arbejde selvfølgelig, så lavede man det til nationaldag. Det er klart, at det er
Yes, Martin, now you are teaching English, mathematics, and also music.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how do you integrate democracy and citizenship in your classrooms? Or
democracy is very difficult to integrate into music because I have to be the leader in the music lessons. In mathematics and English, you try to make the pupils learn to listen to other people, to accept other ideas by letting them work two and two and in groups and sometimes the whole class. And they try to learn to accept each other and accept other ideas than their own. And that can be quite difficult.
Yeah, but are they learning about democracy in the classroom?
Only in the older classes, in like 7, 8 and 9. In the smaller, they have we have a pupils council, where two pupils from each class gets elected to a pupils council, where they take some decisions about what happens here in this part of the school. Typically, about what to hang on the walls or what to do for special days and things like that.
So they can change some stuff in the school.
Yeah, a little. Yeah. Even I can't change very much.
And I wonder, they usually say that mathematics is full of formulas or everything is clear, so you don't have to think about anything. I mean, your own ideas are not important because everything is clear. 2 + 2 = 4. And
but you saw how... I know what you're going to ask because you saw the mathematics lessons today and they have to decide which paper flyer to fly themselves. They have to work in small groups, and one of the groups got four girls got very angry and only made one flight actually, and one of the girls began crying. So I had to talk to them and say, "Come on, Natasha, it was listen to the others, accept the others' ideas. Isn't that democracy as well?
Yeah.
To try to accept other ideas."
Yes.
I think.
You're right, but you are doing like group work and.
Yes.
That's how you integrate democracy in...
Sometimes, but I also think it's a matter of who you are as a person, who the teacher is.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I'm a dictator in my classroom, there's no there's no democracy at all.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to be willing to accept the children as well.
Mm-hmm.
And that sometimes is difficult when you have a child who is... making a lot of noise or annoying.
Mm-hmm.
It can be difficult, but I have to accept that child as well. So a lot of democracy work, I think, is not working with somebody else,
mm-hmm.
but working with yourself.
Yes, you take everybody as individual and accept
yes.
their ideas.
Yes.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I think the community that we are all there is very important as well. So it's this mixture between one and everybody.
Yes.
And everybody should be accepted by the one, but everybody should accept the one as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
yeah. So you make sure that everyone is included in the classroom.
I try.
No one feels isolated.
I try.
Yeah. and especially for those kids who are from different ethnic backgrounds or...
That is very seldom the problem, because we have very few, as you saw. We have two or three or four in each class.
Yeah.
The ones who are not accepted by the others are typical children who isolate themselves, whose self-esteem is very bad. They don't think well about themselves. They think they are stupid or ugly or anything or something. And they keep back and say to the others, keep away. And their distance is very far away. So I think it's very often a social problem, more than an ethnic problem. But maybe that's because we only have the few other ethnic backgrounds in this school. I don't know.
And I'd like to ask something about citizenship.
Yes.
Do you have any class like Danish citizenship or?
Yes, we have that in 7th, 8th, and 9th class. They have a subject called social studies or science about the social life, where they have to learn about the government in Denmark and how we rule this little part of Denmark, and civil rights and the United Nations and so on.
They are learning a lot.
Yes, they learn, but they have books about it.
Yeah, but are they taking actions? I mean, are they kind of a politic? Do they believe that they
no,
can
they,
change?
No, they don't care about politics.
Yeah.
They don't care at all about it, because they're born and raised in Denmark. And they never had to fight for anything, so they take it for granted. But if you lived in Egypt or maybe Libya, you have to fight for it, and you get a much stronger feeling for it. These Danish kids, they're spoiled. And they're spoiled, you know. They had it all from birth. Okay, yes, of course I have a saying. Of course my mother and father would listen to me. Of course my teacher would listen to me. So they never had to fight for it. So it's first when they travel that they see that life can be otherwise. So.
And do you think that education system is nationalistic or
more global?
More global.
It depends on the teacher.
Yeah, but what about the curriculum? What the curriculum says?
It's global.
Global.
Yes, very.
In terms of that,
we mentioned that they have to learn about different nationalities. Mm-hmm. It's said so in the law, and they have to learn about other cultures.
Yes.
And of course, that in music and in Danish and in history, we know that they have to learn Danish history, mm-hmm, and Danish music. But international aspect is mentioned. Human rights are mentioned in our curriculum.
So it's more global.
There are also noget andet.
Thank you very much, Martin.
Not at all.
Thank you very much. That was it.
You didn't say that.